So the third research project in question is the Vitreous Floaters Functional Questionnaire and Plans for Dissemination. This is a questionnaire that we've designed to be better than the National Eye Institute's visual function questionnaire because it's more specifically related to floaters. And I think this is an actual paradigm of what we're doing this morning, how we are interacting this morning. And the reason for that is that this questionnaire was originally something that Dymock Brett and colleagues at One Clear Vision designed, meaning they polled each other and they developed a questionnaire that had 60 some odd questions related to floaters. And Dymock provided those questions to me and with a colleague whose name is Alfredo Sadoun. He's a neuro-ophthalmologist and MD PhD at the Doheny Eye Institute, now part of UCLA. We selected 34 questions that seemed most relevant and best sculpted for this application and used that questionnaire to query our patients who come in complaining of floaters. And we've done studies correlating the results of the VFFQ, the Vitreous Floaters Functional Questionnaire, with the VFQ, which is the Visual Function Questionnaire of the National Eye Institute, that being, so to speak, the gold standard. And we also used both of those to evaluate the status of patients pre and post vitrectomy for floaters and showed, and let me take a step back. The reason for this is in using the visual function questionnaire, although we have shown in previous studies correlations with contrast sensitivity function and vitreous density, I was disappointed when we used that questionnaire to determine the response to vitrectomy because generally speaking, the patients are extremely happy to be completely rid of all their floaters. And yet the VFQ did not reflect more than a 20 to 30% improvement. And I didn't understand why. And one of the possible answers is it's the problem with the questionnaire. When we used the VFFQ, the Vitreous Floaters Functional Questionnaire, it was in excess of 60%, which started to make more sense. And so we wrote that up and we submitted it and it was not accepted for publication because we didn't have independent validation studies of the visual of the Vitreous Floaters Functional Questionnaire. So we're currently in the process of recruiting patients and assembling that. But again, for the reasons I described earlier, our patient volume has been severely affected this past year. And we've only been able to recruit an additional 15 subjects by last count. And I think we need 20 or 30 more. So we're not far, but hopefully the volume of patients will increase and we'll be able to complete that. We'll be able to present the validation studies in conjunction with the test that I just described, the pre and post vitrectomy test, and get that published. Once that is published, we can discuss how best to disseminate the questionnaire, how best to utilize the questionnaire in our work with respect to outreach and providing a service to patients, because I can envision two applications at the very least. One, a system of triage for us to determine severity of disease based on the questionnaire, but also I think as a service to patients to test themselves and to see where they stand. We have to be careful because providing that kind of information might, we have to do it very responsibly and very carefully. And I don't quite know exactly how to do it, but I think together you and I can figure out a way to utilize this questionnaire